morning, everyone.
Just
another example of why West is best, right there.
Right.
We have the best students in the area, no doubt about it. I'd like to welcome everyone to West Scranton Intermediate School, where I say it's always sunny and 80. Rainbows always land right on West Intermediate. This morning we are here to celebrate the outstanding accomplishments of three of our 8th grade students, Ms. Molly Dougherty, Ms. Camdyn Lewis, and Ms. Ava Decker. These young ladies worked diligently on a voluntary social studies project in which they had to plan, create, and edit a video. This extensive project took 8 months to complete. They were guided by two dedicated and dynamic educators, Mrs. Aaron Mangan and Mr. Dean Mulhern. The girls chose to focus on gun violence and the need to find a solution. Their documentary is impressive. Along the way, they got to meet and interview a United States Senator, a Duke University professor, the Philadelphia Police Commissioner, an NRA representative, and the co-founder of Sandy Hook Promise, which is an organization whose sole purpose is to prevent gun violence in our country. Their 7-minute documentary was submitted to C-SPAN's StudentCam competition, as were over 2,900 other films. I'm absolutely thrilled to tell you that their documentary placed first nationally. These young ladies are national champions. Before we show the video, we have some very special guests here this morning that are here to help us celebrate, and I'd like to welcome them to West Intermediate. First off, Molly's family, especially her mom, Patricia, and she's crying. And as her father, we couldn't be more proud. Camden's family, especially her parents, Nicole and Trevor, and Ava's family, especially her parents, Laura and Jim. And I'd also like to introduce West Scranton's past C-SPAN Student Cam winners, including 2014 third place winners, 11th grade students, Miss Emily White, Miss Destiny Cristiano, Miss Maria Benedict. And last year's second place winners, 9th grade students Miss Fiona Evans and Miss Abby O'Brien. Also here with us this morning is our superintendent, Dr. Alexis Kirian. School Board President, Mr. Bob Sheridan. Our Central Office Administrators, you have to clap real loud for them because they're my boss, okay? Ms. Keating and Ms. McTernan, they're hiding back there in the back underneath the plaque. Additional dignitaries, including Mr. Bob Morgan, who's the District Director for U.S. Congressman Matt Cartwright. We have Scranton Mayor, Mr. William Portwright. We have Scranton City Council members, Mr. Joseph Wexler and Mr. Pat Rogan. We have Scranton City Clerk, I think Mrs. Lori Reed is here, I think. We have Scranton Fire Department Chief, Mr. Pat DeSarno. We have Lackawanna County Commissioner, my friend, Mr. Pat O'Malley. We have Representative Marty Flynn's Chief of Staff, Mr. Thomas Welby. Oh, there he is. He came in a little late. Also, one of my close friends, Marty Flynn. Mr. Flynn's a former boxer, too. Professional boxer. We switched haircuts a couple years ago. I'd also like to introduce Ms. Elizabeth Sterner, who's Comcast Senior Director for Government and Community Affairs. Thank you. that might not be familiar with C-SPAN, it's a television network that was founded. It began in 1979. And since its inception, C-SPAN has pursued its mission to make government more open to the American public. It telecasts political proceedings in millions of households across the country. In fact, its audience is extremely large. It's available in over 100 million American homes. And on April 17th, this past Monday, Molly Camdyn and Ava's winning video was broadcast nationally on C-SPAN. And then in just a few minutes, Joel's going to share a few words with us. At this time, I'm extremely proud to present Molly Camdyn and Ava's winning video, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Puzzle.
I'm here in front of the U.S. Capitol building, which is right near the White House. Washington, D.C. is our nation's capital, where the President and Congress focus on the issues that face our nation today.
After research and interviews, we have become aware that prevention of gun violence has many aspects and is a complex issue.
However, too many lives have been lost and are at risk in the future if something doesn't change. Therefore, the most urgent issue that the President and Congress should focus on is
the prevention of gun violence.
The first component of the gun violence puzzle is victims.
When tragedy strikes, victims of gun violence tend to grab the attention of the national media. Many people call for action in the aftermath of these painful events, but it begins to fade with time, resulting in no improvement upon the issue.
Gun violence was absolutely nowhere on my radar before Sandy Hook. I lived in England for 18 years, where there is not a gun violence issue. I moved to Newtown in 2011, and less than 2 years later, my son was killed. This is something that I had no clue about, and I would hear about it in the news and just think how awful it was, but never thought it could happen to me.
Many groups attempt to get gun legislation passed, but to no avail. Legislation never seems to make it past Congress, making it difficult to shine light on the gun-related issues of our country.
Here's the problem. The bad guys are always going to get the guns. You can have all the restrictions you want, but the bad guys are always going to have the guns.
What can a legislative body like the United States Senate do when it comes to confronting the horror of gun violence and also the tragedy that gun violence leaves across our country, America? Is the kind of country we say, we may not solve this problem in 6 months or 2 years, but if we put our minds to it and work on it day after day and then year after year, we're going to greatly reduce that number of more than 33,600 way down.
Every day, police officers make a commitment to protect our community and keep the people in it safe. In order to complete the task of trying to find ways to minimize the level of gun violence, we must learn to work with each other.
I think a source of frustration, at least for me and some of my colleagues, I don't speak for everybody, particularly in big cities, is that we spend a lot of time trying to keep young people alive. And so we need more partners in the fight with us, and some are with us, but we need some people more in it more consistently in order for us to win this fight against gun violence in the country.
The Second Amendment is the right to bear arms in the United States. We must find a way to balance the rights stated in the Second Amendment while also finding ways to make our country a safer place. NRA spokespeople like Catherine Morrison work diligently every day to find ways to harmonize these two contrasting sides.
But the question is, so frequently after these incidents, there's a movement to pass more gun laws. Have to say, would it have made a difference? And in all of these cases we've had of these mass shootings, these individuals who committed these crimes, they passed background checks. Time and again we see that background checks cannot stop these people all the time. So just passing more gun laws isn't the solution.
Although mental health issues are factors in the prevention of gun violence, it would be unfair to blame mentally ill individuals as the major cause. Rather, we feel we should invest more resources into helping those with mental illness.
The vast majority of people with mental illnesses, even serious mental illnesses, are not violent towards other people and never will be. And in fact, serious mental illness accounts for only about 4%. Right. It's also a complicated problem. You know, sometimes people ask me, what's the one thing that we should do to end gun violence in the United States? And I say it's not a one thing problem, and it's not a one thing solution. Gun violence and gun violence prevention, it's like a big jigsaw puzzle, and the solution involves many pieces that are going to fit together.
Since 2007, according to the FBI, there have been 146 reported mass shootings. Far too often, a large contributing factor to this recent surge in violence is untreated mental illness.
Let's not forget about issues with race and socioeconomic influences. Statistics have shown that people who live in lower income homes are more prone to being victims of gun violence, and more specifically, young African American males.
What is so pervasive is the incidence of gun violence that impacts young men, particularly young men of color. That seems to be a staple, but the things that happen seems to day in and day out across this nation in big cities is the gun violence that impacts young men of color.
Sportsmen and hunters use their guns for recreational purposes.
Position that the sheriffs or the police chiefs have taken that would take guns out of the hands of people who hunt, who use them for recreation, for sport. We're not trying to take guns away from anybody, but we're just trying to institute some common sense measures that would keep our community safer. And
these additional factors are pieces in the puzzle, but there is more to discuss to complete it.
Is that gun violence is preventable, that there are actions we can all take in our families and in our communities to make lives safer. But I think if we all know that this is not a hopeless issue, this is not a helpless issue, there are actions we can take right now to get engaged and help save the lives of our kids and our friends and our family, then we'll save a lot of lives while Congress is still figuring out how they're going to find a way to work together. But without conversations, without open dialogue, without listening, which is what Sandy Hook Promise is built on, then we're not going to get anywhere. And every day we keep fighting, more people die. And I can't accept that.
Nicole Hackley stated that gun violence was nowhere on her radar until her son passed away. We think that many Americans think this way. We have learned that gun violence should be on everyone's radar. It doesn't only affect one city, it continues to leave its mark on our country. So, we believe that the most urgent issue for the new president and Congress to address in 2017 should be the prevention of gun violence, because it's a complicated puzzle that needs to be solved.
On their own, Molly, Camdyn, and Ava decided that they were going to donate significant portion of their winnings to Sandy Hook Promise. Now, you're the true embodiment of my favorite phrase. I already said it once here today, but the West is best. You're a perfect example of that. Our first speaker today is Lackawanna County Commissioner, Mr. Patrick O'Mell.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's an honor and privilege to be here. Back in 1984, I graduated from West Scranton Intermediate School. I bleed blue just like everyone in this room. Also, back in 1985, your principal, Mr. Dougherty, so we're very old. Camdyn, Ava, Molly, all of us see the news, all of us hear the stories. The police are getting killed in the streets. Sandy Hook Elementary School, Columbine, all scary situations, needless deaths, things that should never have happened. And the three of you made a video about how we should be trying to stop it and prevent it. It really matters. And you guys are first place overall in the nation after C-SPAN. Think about that. Think about all the schools. Think about all the students. Think about the investment and time that everybody else put in. And you guys won. That is fabulous. I mean, well, this is a very happy Friday for everyone because it's Friday, but also to the three ladies. At this time, I'd like to have Camdyn Lewis come forward. I'd like for our Molly Dougherty to come forward. And I'd like for Ava Decker to come forward. Certificates of recognition. County of Lackawanna Board of Commissioners does hereby recognize Ava Decker, West Scranton Intermediate School, in the honor of achievement of first place winner in the National 2017 C-SPAN StudentCam Video Contest, given the 21st day of April 2017. On behalf of the 214,000 citizens, by Patrick O'Malley, Jerry Notarietti, and Commissioner Lorraine Cummings. Certificate of recognition. The County of Lackawanna Board of Commissioners does hereby recognize Camdyn Lewis, West Grand Intermediate School, in honor of achieving first place winner of the National 2017 C-SPAN Student Cam Video Contest, given the 21st day of April 2017, on behalf of 214,000 citizens, by Commissioner Patrick O'Malley, Jerry Notarietti, and Lorraine E. Cummings. Certificate of recognition. The County of Lackawanna Board of Commissioners does hereby recognize Molly Dougherty, West Grand Intermediate School, in honor of your achievement of the first place winner in the National 2017 C-SPAN Student Cam Video Contest, given the 21st day of April 2017, on behalf of 214,000 citizens, by Commissioner Patrick O'Malley, Commissioner Jerry Notarietti, and Commissioner Lorraine Cummings. Congratulations to the parents of your special children and to the teacher and to the administration at West Intermediate School. And absolutely what Mr. Dougherty just said, West is best. Thank you very much.
I tell students all the time, I sat in orange chairs. I'd like to invite Scranton School Board President Mr. Bob Sheridan to share a few words with us.
Good morning, and a special welcome to the students, staff, parents of the West Scranton Intermediate, Mr. Dougherty, Mrs. Boyce, Dr. Kerrion, fellow board members, and of course, C-SPAN. On behalf of the Scranton School Board of Directors, I would like to express how incredibly proud we are of the academic excellence amplified by the outstanding students and teachers of the West Scranton Intermediate School. For the last 2 years, West Scranton Intermediate participated and placed in the annual nationwide C-SPAN StudentCam documentary competition. This year's project, spearheaded by Ava Decker, Molly Dougherty, and Camdyn Lewis, tackled gun control in the project entitled United States Gun Violence, a Complicated Issue. Their hard work, diligence has paid off with the first place finish in a nationwide contest. Yes, first place. As well as we all know, the controversial policy issue and these exceptional students, with the help of their dedicated teachers, were enabled to gain access and interview people in some of our most influential local, state, and federal decision-making circles, including United States Senator Robert P. Casey, Philadelphia Police Commissioner Richard Ross, NRA National Spokesman Catherine Mortensen, and Duke University Professor of Psychiatry Jeffrey Sims. Furthermore, in an important moment of documentary, these students discussed in a true-life ramifications of gun violence with Nicole Hockley, a parent who lost her son, Dylan, during the tragic events of the Sandy Hook massacre. With that said, we would like to congratulate Mr. Dougherty and his staff, especially teachers Aaron Megan and Dean Mill Mahern, and Ava, Molly, and Camdyn, for your efforts have again highlighted the top-notch academics that West Scranton Intermediate is well known for. This accomplishment is truly remarkable. You three students have incredibly bright futures ahead of yourselves, and we, the Scranton School Board of Directors, will be closely following your endeavors. Achievement and accomplishment of Ava Decker is recognized by the academic excellence of the first prize middle school division winner of the C-SPAN class student cam documentary contest. Ava. The certificate of achievement acknowledges that Molly Dougherty, in recognition of academic excellence in the first prize middle school division, winner of the C-SPAN Classroom Student Cam Documentary Contest. Certificate achievement that acknowledges that Camdyn Lewis is recognized for the academic excellence as the first prize middle school division winner of the C-SPAN Classroom Student Cam Documentary Contest.
Exceptional young women. They're truly wonderful to have in the classroom, and I'm and happy I got to know them a little better through doing this. So it's a credit to you guys, truly. Also, Mr. Mulhern, the other teacher who works on this project, he likes to be behind the scenes. He's often the one who's taking the photos. He's actually back there right now. And this absolutely does not get done without you. So thank you as well. Fantastic project to participate in. It lends itself to bringing learning outside of the classroom, and you know, it enables so many things. Like you can incorporate such as STEAM, technology, and the arts shines in a project like this. They did so many things to put this together. They put in months of effort. You know, they set up the interviews. They did the filming. They did editing. They wrote the dialogue. You know, just even being in front of the camera. And it's such a heavy topic as well. And to do all that flawlessly is amazing because they're only in eighth grade. Most people wouldn't be able to do that. This also brings out my competitive spirit. I used to be an assistant coach, girls basketball coach in this building for many years until my children were born. So being able to compete is wonderful. You know, we're very competitive. We do great things in this building, but to be number one academically is phenomenal. When you think about it, you know, you're surely going to take away many memories for this and the experience. As we said, you know, they've interviewed senators, other people that they've interviewed for this. Some people won't get to experience in their lifetime. So to say that I'm proud of you is a complete understatement. I'm proud of you for so many reasons. I'm proud that you're doing something positive. Commissioner, we watch the news, and oftentimes it's more than not something negative. So to see something positive right here in this building is awesome. You're a great example for people in the community and our school district, and lastly, West. And I also think West is best because I went to this school as well. But I'm most proud of, you know, wonderful people that you are, and I'm proud of, you know, to be your teacher. I'm proud of these girls. Oh, I'm so happy that you're back with us today, and it's just a wonderful thing to be a part of, and I definitely look forward to see what the future holds for all of you. So thank you very much.
Our next honored guest is the mayor of our great city, Mr. William Corcoran. I'm a West Sider like everyone else here, but these were woods when I was a kid. There was some education going on here, but not the kind you think of. So girls, I have a proclamation on behalf of the city. I'm just going to read it one time, it's a little bit lengthy. But I know your principal, the school district, and the students, and your parents especially are proud of you. But I want you to know the entire city of Scranton is proud of you. I leaned back and said to Molly's mom, I know Molly since she's a little girl. She's all dressed up there. She looks like a young lady now. So on behalf of the city of Scranton, I'd like to read this proclamation to you. Whereas, because of the outstanding efforts of these three West Scranton students in creating a video documentary that detailed a variety of gun violence issues, they're deserving of special recognition. And whereas, over the course of 10 months, these creative and civic-minded students thoroughly researched community, state, and national gun violence issues, developed interview questions, interviewed policymakers, chose and shot on-location video footage, and edited audio-video components of the project aimed at convincing the President and the Congress to discuss and prevent gun violence nationally. And whereas these three students distinguished themselves by being awarded first place in the 2017 National C-SPAN StudentCam documentary.
Thank you.
For their U.S. Gun Violence, a Complicated Puzzle video. Whereas through their hard work and dedication to their project, they have made their parents, teachers, and their city proud. And whereas I would like to take this opportunity to commend Ava, Molly, and Camdyn for bringing great credit upon themselves, the Scranton School District, and their community.
And therefore now I, William L. Courtright, Mayor of the City of Scranton, would like to recognize and applaud the outstanding efforts and remarkable achievements of Ava Decker, Molly Dougherty, and Camdyn Lewis. And I urge all citizens of the City of Scranton to congratulate them on a job well done. Congratulations. So, Mr. Billy, I have one for the school. For the school also, maybe you could display it somewhere.
Absolutely.
I'll give this one to you.
Okay.
Holly, Camdyn, and Ava.
Next this morning to honor these young ladies is a longtime friend of mine, probably go back 20 years. Mr. Bob Morgan, who's the District Director for U.S. Congressman Matt Carpenter.
Good morning, how are you? My name is Bob Morgan, I'm District Director for Congressman Matt Cartwright, and what I'm about to read is a little bit of history here. This is the congressional record, and so what happens is Congressman Cartwright submitted this, and this will be something that anybody can look up years from now. In recognition of Camdyn and Ava and Molly, would you please join me along with Mrs. Mank? In recognition of Camdyn Lewis, Ava Decker, and Molly Dougherty for winning first place in the middle school division for the 2017 National C-SPAN StudentCam Video Contest. Mr. Speaker, I rise today to honor Camdyn Lewis, Ava Decker, and Molly Dougherty of West Scranton Intermediate School. These three eighth grade students, with the help of their social studies teacher, Aaron Mangan, came in first place in the middle school division of the 2017 National C-SPAN StudentCam Video Contest. The student's prize-winning entry is entitled U.S. Gun Violence, a Complicated Puzzle. The seven-minute piece covers the victims, legislation, law enforcement, mental health, and socioeconomic aspects of gun violence, and included interviews with leaders who work in areas related to firearm policy. Those featured in the film were Nicole Hockley, whose son Dylan was a victim of the Sandy Hook shooting, U.S. Senator Bob Casey, Philadelphia Police Commissioner Richard Ross Jr., NRA spokesperson Catherine Mortensen, and Jeffrey W. Swanson, a PhD professor in psychiatry and behavioral sciences at Duke University. The video urges Congress and the President to take action to reduce the number of gun-related casualties in the country, but also calls viewers of the piece to action to prevent incidents of gun violence in their communities. It is an honor to recognize that these three young women for covering such an important issue with sensitivity and tact. I congratulate them on winning the 2017 National C-SPAN StudentCam Video Contest. I applaud the faculty and staff at West Scranton Intermediate School for helping these students make a successful video project. Camdyn, Ava and Molly should be proud of the exceptional piece of journalism they produced. The Honorable Matt Cartwright submitted Thursday, April 6, 2017. So congratulations.
Scranton City Council, please welcome President Mr. Joseph Wexler and Vice President Mr. Pat Rowe.
I think I'm the only one that's not from West Sider. But I am an honorary West Sider. My wife grew up on Dessert Street. So everything always comes back to West Side, and you can't get away from it, and I do agree that West is best. Oh, thank you for having me.
before Council President reads the proclamations, there's just a couple things not in the proclamations that I do want to mention. As a fellow Westsider, I sat in these chairs as well. It seems like just yesterday. But I do want to give a huge congratulations to the three girls on your accomplishments, your teachers, your principal, the school district. This proves not only that West Scranton can compete on a national level, but we can win on a national level. And that's why West is best. One other thing I want to point out, there's a number of elected officials and dignitaries here today, but specifically Commissioner O'Malley, our Mayor Bill Courtright, our Fire Chief, Chief Lissardo, and our State Representative Marty Flynn, as well as myself. Can anyone guess what section of the city we're all from? West Scranton.
He just proved my point.
So congratulations again, and our superintendents from West Side as well. So. I'll turn it back over to our council president. Congratulations, and you really are the proof that West is best, so thank you.
Whereas the Council of the City of Scranton is desirous of honoring Ava Decker, Molly Dougherty, Camdyn Lewis, three West Scranton Intermediate School 8th grade students for their outstanding achievement, and whereas Ava, Molly, and Camdyn won first prize in the middle school division of the 2017 C-SPAN StudentCam video contest for their video entitled U.S. Gun Violence, a Complicated Puzzle. And whereas of the 2,903 documentaries entered, only 150 were awarded a prize, and Ava, Molly, and Camdyn video was just the best of all middle school entries nationally. And whereas Ava, Molly, and Camdyn receive a prize of $3,000 and will donate $1,500 of that prize to the Sandy Hook Promise Organization to help prevent further gun violence. The girls will share the rest of the prize equally among the three of them. Their social studies teacher, Mrs. Erin Mangan, will receive $500 from C-SPAN to purchase technology resources for their classroom. And whereas Ava is a member of the reading team and art club, Molly is a member of the Pennsylvania Junior Academy of Science and STEM Club, and Camdyn is member of the Ski Club and STEM Club. In addition, all three girls are members of the Student Council, Drama Club, and Yearbook Club. And whereas Ava, Molly, and Camdyn are outstanding students and plan to attend college. Now therefore, resolved that on Friday, April 21, 2017, Scranton City Council wishes to congratulate Ava Decker, Molly Dougherty, and Camdyn Lewis for their outstanding accomplishments and extend their best wishes for success to their families and teachers. We have further resolved that this proclamation be made a permanent record of this council, a lasting tribute to Ava Decker, Molly Dougherty, and Camdyn Lewis. And this is signed by City Council, myself, Vice President Rogan, William Gaughan, Wayne Evans, and Timothy Perry.
Next is Comcast Senior Director for Government and Community Affairs, Ms. Elizabeth Sterner.
Good morning. I have to admit, I'm not from around here. But I have to tell you, I'm convinced West is definitely best. And Molly, Ava, Camdyn, and girls rule. I am so proud of this program and Comcast's long history of supporting C-SPAN and StudentCam. If you didn't know it, C-SPAN is funded wholly by cable companies. So Comcast and the rest of the cable industry are what make it possible for the channel. And uh, I, I don't know about you, but I think it's money well spent. I think it's money well spent. I've been doing this for a really long time. This is my very first place winners. I have been, sort of hopping on the balls of my feet since I found out, and not surprised that it was Scranton, because this is like the center of StudentCam. I believe that we're up here every year to recognize someone from this school or from one of the others, so you must be doing something right. It is great, and Molly, Camdyn, Ava, I have to tell you that the company I work for is now a global media, technology, and entertainment company. I watch one heck of a lot of video, and I was not just impressed, I was in awe of how well and how creatively you put that together and presented such a difficult topic. It was just, congratulations. It was just a wonderful job. And congratulations to the school and the parents and everyone involved. And thank you so much for that.
At this time, I'd like to welcome C-SPAN representative, Mr. Joel Bacon. Please welcome.
So I picked up on the cue. If I say West is best, everyone clap, right? This is by far the best part of my job. I work in D.C., 52 weeks out of the year. But I get to come out, and every year we do the StudentCam documentary film competition, and to see the talent that is out there. I've told a couple of people, I've worked in production for 2.5 years, and when I see videos like this, I get jealous. I don't know how they do it sometimes. I am, enthralled to congratulate Ava, Molly, and Camdyn. And so the point, why does C-SPAN do this? So what is C-SPAN? C-SPAN is the cable satellite public affairs network. We exist, just like your principal said, to give people a voice that might not have a voice. We have everything about C-SPAN is to make sure that people in real voices heard by people in Washington. We do that in our programs, and one thing you might notice about C-SPAN is that we're never going to tell you what to believe. Our job is not to give you an opinion, our own opinion. No one at C-SPAN is going to ever tell you what their position is on any issue, other than we want cameras in the Supreme Court as well. We'll see when that happens. But we're not going to tell you what to believe. We are, just like Liz said, we are a public service. We are not funded by the government, so the government can't tell us what to cover, what not to cover. We want to be the best seat in the House for people from, Scranton, Pennsylvania, or people from Chula Vista, California, to be able to see the same exact thing, to see what's going on, and hear from you guys what your opinions are. So that's why, especially, we do StudentCam. We do it because people in D.C., if you haven't noticed, might not always have an answer to a question, a difficult question. Sometimes all you hear is rhetoric, and there's no deep dive into how you actually solve a problem. That's why we love StudentCam. That's why we love politics in general. Is we love seeing who is out there and what you guys have to see. So I'll tell you at this time, everyone else, thank you so much for coming out, all of the elected officials. I want you to take a look. All of these elected officials have watched your video. It's in their minds now. These are videos that have been watched by senators. They've been watched by representatives. Your words, your ideas that you worked 8 months on have been seen by the people you want to affect. So congratulations about that. gave you certificates of congratulations. I'm going to give you the actual certificate of award now. So if you guys will all come forward. All right, for Ava Decker, first prize, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Puzzle, West Scranton Intermediate School, signed by our Executive Chairman Brian Lamb and our President and CEO Susan Swinton. Congratulations. Camdyn Lewis, first prize, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Puzzle, West Scranton Intermediate School, Scranton, Pennsylvania. First prize, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Story, Puzzle. West Scranton Intermediate School, Scranton, Pennsylvania. Congratulations. And if you'll stay up here for just a second, he wasn't able to come, but Governor Tom Wolf has also sent letters of congratulations, and I'll read those to you now. It is my pleasure to congratulate you and your team on placing first in the 2017 National C-SPAN StudentCam Video Contest for your video, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Puzzle. Pennsylvania possesses a rich heritage of individuals who have made noteworthy contributions to our communities and the Commonwealth. Your video on gun violence offers a comprehensive perspective on an issue that merits frank discussion. I applaud your efforts to engage with lawmakers, victims, and other stakeholders to present a balanced portrayal of the problem of gun violence. Your work highlights your dedication to your fellow citizens and to improving both the Commonwealth and our nation as a whole. From your research and writing to the production, the skills you've developed on this project will serve you well throughout your life. You have represented the Commonwealth with great distinction, and I look forward to your progress as you pursue your education and goals. As governor, and on behalf of all citizens of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I am delighted to honor this wonderful accomplishment. Please accept my best wishes for your continued success. Congratulations, one more round of applause. West is best. There's one very important thing that I had forgotten. One second. You three will come back up here real quick. We forgot to give him the check.
Video, U.S. Gun Violence, A Complicated Puzzle. If you told us last August that we were going to win first prize, we probably would have laughed and told you that you were lying. But today, our wildest dreams came true. We wouldn't have been able to do this without the people we interviewed. Senator Casey, Catherine Morrison, Commissioner Ross, Jeff Swanson, and Nicole Hockley. Although Nicole is unable to attend our ceremony today, we are donating $1,500 to our organization, Sandy Hook Promise.
We also couldn't have done this without the constant support from our family and friends, along with our school, West Intermediate.
C-SPAN StudentCam ceremony. We hope you enjoyed your time here at our school, West Intermediate.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming to West Intermediate this morning, especially our honored guests, our distinguished guests. Some guests I forgot to mention as they came in. I think Mr. Bert Genelez is back there. He's a central office administrator, former principal at West High. We always love Mr. Genelez in the building. And I'd also like to thank John Menora, our district solicitor, for coming out at this time. In just a second, we're going to dismiss our sixth grade students back to class. But I'm going to ask that Molly, Camdyn, and Ava, if you'll escort our guests into the cafeteria for some light refreshments. Thank you very much, everyone, and have a great day.